Once we'd actually got our first bike together, and that maybe took 2 or 3 months to get to that point, we then went back into the CFD with our first real bike, if you like. And I think we had our first run was a drag saving of something like 50% compared with the Hayabusa. And at that point, I went, Rob's got a real project here.
Did you believe it?
To be honest, my default is to not believe it and to go, well, that can't be right. And but as you look at the data and you look at analyze the flow, you start to see what it is and actually that there's still some improvements to be had. Rob was always looking for, you know, another 10% here and there, which doesn't exist, but every little change we make, we pull surfaces in and out and we find another 0.5% and optimize it. And in the end, we end up finding another 20-odd%. But there's no magic bullets in that one. The magic bullet is the
work through. Yeah.
The first thing is on the front suspension. Obviously, we need to have bump travel, we need steer, and all of these gaps in here obviously need to be managed to allow for that. But at the same time, we don't want the air to get stuck against the front of the belly pan and create a high pressure area here.
And the hub center steering?
The hub center steering is, it's a necessary solution effectively to remove the need for forks and allow us to keep the clean air straight across the top. But it fits quite nicely in these shapes in that we drew the shapes that we wanted right from the front end, as Rob says, all the way down the bike to keep this one smooth curve. And that gave us some volume and naturally sits with the steering cables we could get out of the way. But we still need to internally have enough room for steering lock and for bump and droop.
And we also have two electric motors within the hub.
Yeah, and I mean, if you look at it from front view, those electric motors are tucked within the brake disc. So we've had to go a little bit bigger on brake disc.
Quite often you'd have brake disc spaced out, yeah. But the whole bike is optimized. So you're within almost the tire profile there.
Yeah, and I mean, there's a lot going on in the front wheel. It's a bespoke front wheel, but we managed to package all of the motors within that. I think there's two things though. First of all is the concept. I think it is an amazing concept. And actually, like you say, the numbers make a big difference. But the other one is Rob's passion about it. That's what got us interested in the project. And I think no ideas are bad ideas. You know, you need people that are gonna push you. I'm always gonna try and be practical and make sure that it's feasible and works. But at the same time, you need to be able to be pushed and challenge some of your preconceptions.
I mean, what we want to do with this really is we want to demonstrate British engineering and innovation, and we want to be a team of people that is engineering led, that can go out and take on big budget teams, you know, from around Europe that we're looking to challenge, and we're looking to beat them based on engineering skill and execution, and I think we can do it.